All right, well, Wine Week continues, and I am joined by a winemaker, founder of Ravenswood Winery in Sonoma, California, right?
Sonoma, California.
Yeah, this is Joel Peterson, and you're known as the godfather of Zin.
I am. I must have told somebody they'd be sleeping with the fishes if they didn't drink my Zin.
I love it. So have you had a nice time in New Hampshire this week?
I've had a great time in New Hampshire. Great. This is the Wine Week, of course, and you get to see a lot of your customers, and it's so much fun to talk to them and to get their feedback on your wines.
Yeah, and we're joined also by Christopher Noble from blueAqua Restaurant and Bar. And what are
Correct.
You going to be making, pairing with the wine that's been brought here today?
Well, when I think of a nice Zinfandel, I always think of lamb. I always go to lamb. And I've been a fan of Ravenswood for at least 15 years now when I tried it at the resort that used to feature it all the time. So lamb, Zin goes great together.
All right, so how do we start off here? You have your pan all heated up here, and that looks great. So what do people need to, when pairing wine, what should we know? How do we know what goes with what?
Well, let's just look at something like lamb. So lamb has very profound flavors. It's a strong flavor, and there's a certain amount of fattiness that goes with it. So you want a wine that'll have a certain amount of assertiveness, and you also want a wine that's got good acidity and good tannin, because what that will do is it will ameliorate the fat, so it will make the meat actually taste better, and it will make the meal seem less heavy than it would otherwise seem. So overall, it just gives you a much more pleasing sensation. Now, there are lots of books that are written, you know, many pages long about how to pair food and wine, but it mostly has to do with the acidity, the tannin, and the weight of the food.
Okay, and you brought some wines here, and we were talking a little bit about Ravenswood, and tell us a little bit about what you did bring in today.
I brought in really three different categories of wine. I make a very inexpensive wine that sells for $6.99 in the state, which is the most consumed Zinfandel in the world these days, over $72 a case. I brought in some of my regional wines. We'll have the Sonoma County with the lamb. It's a big, rich wine made from vines that average age 85 years old. And then I brought in some of my single vineyard designated wines, which are the most expensive wines I make, but they're also the most precise low production wines. They're from vineyards that were planted as long ago as 1885 to 1888.
That's amazing.
Yeah, so
we were talking briefly, and we don't have much more time left, and we do have the finished meal over there, which looks lovely, but the drought, it might have a significant impact, you think,
it
on the wine industry?
It could have profound effects. It's certainly going to limit the crops. Hopefully it will not kill the vines. Much of my vines are dry farms, so they really rely on the water you get during the year.
Well, I hope that all is well in your area, definitely, and we get some rain out there to keep those grapes happy.
Send some of your rain and you're cool to us.
I know.
It.
Wonderful to meet you, and thank you very much. This
thank
looks
you.
Really lovely. Again, Christopher Great. Is from blueAqua Restaurant and Bar, and we'll be right back.
Chef.
Cheers.